Hey traders, Raghee here, and in this free video, we're going to talk about where we sit right now in the broader averages, and we are right at the decision level for whether or not more chatter, hyperbole about the U.S.-China trade war narrative can take this market through this threshold. Because look, it's taken us to the threshold, which is right here. We're right there at a level where if we continue higher, I'm going to have to accept that this market's willing to buy new highs and we're looking at a fresh uptrend, but we're not there yet. So we would need more chatter, probably a little bit more than things are going great. We'd have to see some agreements. We'll see. This market's been willing to rally the broader averages on just hopium, right? I've been talking a lot about hopium lately. So NASDAQ is right there at that threshold. The Dow is right there at that threshold. The transports, the IYT is right there. And even the Russell's been rallying. The Russell, which has been pretty much beat up lately, even this laggard, or I should say leader to the downside, which has been a great short, is up at one of the very bottom of the overbought zone. Now, I will persist in calling this an overbought zone until this market is able to rally higher. Now, remember, what we're seeing is a very interesting battle between two things. Because right now, gang, the data and the macro is still very bearish. It's downright awful. And when I say macro, I'm talking about GDP, I'm talking about monetary policy, I'm talking about inflation targets. You know, this kind of stuff is still indicating a global economic slowdown. And I don't mean just in one or two countries. I mean really across G7 countries. Now, contrast that with some of the news, which is what I call hyperbole. And what we have here is things like US-China. We have things here like, you know, whatever might be pseudo-good, things that don't really have tangible results associated with them, unlike data, right? We get a crude oil inventories number, like we did this week, that wasn't as good, by the way, as the API expectations. That's tangible. What was the count? What was the drawdown? What was the buildup? And by the way, in the premium video, for a lot of you that were perplexed about why on a big EIA print, we could see weakness in crude, why we were short the energies, RB and CL, I'll talk about that. But remember, there's these tangible data results and then there's news. And news doesn't have timing and news doesn't even need any there, right? So like I said, we're at a very interesting point where the market's been willing to rally up, or I should say short sellers have been hesitant to step out in front of the news because more of it comes and the shorts are scared. And I can totally understand that. We're hesitant to want to fade this strength because we might get another round of US-China is going great in the trade war narrative, right? And the market tends to want to rally because the hopium is there. And let's face it, one of these times there will be some there, right? There will be an actual result. And at that point, the rally could be real. But for now, it persists in not just being news, just being hope. All right. So having said that, I know that's not a lot of technical analysis. And that brings up my last point of this video. This market is not moving on technicals right now, gang. This market is utterly ignoring macro and data. This market is very much driven by, will the Federal Reserve of the U.S., you know, will the U.S. Central Bank, the Federal Reserve, will we see lower rates in the U.S. as we go into the September, October, and December meetings? What kind of messaging will the Federal Reserve have about the economy and their plan for rates? And whether or not we could persist in seeing more of this US-China news. If that starts to slow and the central bank is not as dovish as 75 more basis points for the rest of the year, because my gosh, how much more could traders and investors want other than 125 basis point cut per meeting for the rest of the year? That's pretty significant. I don't know that the Federal Reserve can deliver more than that. I'm looking for some weakness into next week. I'm looking for this overbought market to sink right back down into the range. Not into a downtrend, mind you, but back into the range. I'll see you next week.